You can win this sporty truck on the turn of a single card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, and good morning, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. I want you to meet our two lovely dealers. Then we'll meet two contestants, one a champ, one a brand new challenger. And one of them will have a chance of winning a great new truck and a lot of money. So let's get our dealers out here right now. Here they come. They are Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams, our dealers on Card Sharks. It's nice to have three dealers on Card Sharks.
That's right.
Or is it four?
Is there something you want to tell us?
Just three, okay.
Nothing I have to say.
We're going to set it right from the top. Can we do that, ladies? And while you're doing that, we'll get our Card Sharks in here. Come on, Eli and Kim. Hello, Eli.
How you doing? I'm Eli Greenberg.
Hang on a moment. They're applauding for you. Got your power tie on today. You know, yeah. Those are power ties.
Is that what they are?
Yeah, if you're the champ, you wear the power ties.
Very good. I like it very much.
You got $4,050. First time playing the big money. Not bad.
Got it.
Is your wife here?
No, she's not here today, unfortunately.
Well, that's okay. Just don't tell her how much you want.
I'll give her $50.
Good for you. Been married 42 years?
46.
That's why I said 46.
That's right. Yeah. You were right the first time.
How long have you been here in California?
About 10 years now.
From?
Brooklyn.
All right. Good. And you retired?
I'm retired now officially, but part-time I work for the UCLA Athletic Department at all of the sporting events. Either rush or work in the payroll department.
Oh, but that's fun.
Wonderful.
That's
wonderful
great.
Time.
Well, it sounds like you have a nice life.
Right.
Good for you.
Get paid for it, too.
Good. Kevin, how are you?
Hi, Bob.
Welcome to our show.
I'm Kevin Russin, and I go to Norco Senior High School in Norco, California. And I'm going to graduate this year with a class of 88.
Woo!
Yeah!
Well, good. What are you going to do after you graduate from high school?
I want to go to Cal Poly Pomona and study to become a mechanical engineer.
Wonderful. Nice to have you here. You know how to play this game, I assume.
Yeah, I do.
If you win two games, you're our champ. That's really all you have to remember. Lacey's got the cards dealt out. And we're going to start with you, Eli. And the first question of the day goes to our 10 moms who all have 10 or more children. They're in our studio audience. These lovely ladies all have 10 or more kids, the toughest 10 women we could find, I will tell you. Eli, before the show, did you have children, Eli?
Yes, I did.
How many did you have?
Two.
Two. How long have you married? 46 years?
46 years.
What the hell happened to you?
I got tired.
Before the show, we asked these 10 moms, when your kids were growing up, did your home have only one bathroom? How many of these 10 moms said their home did have only one bathroom?
I would say it would be near impossible for one bathroom. It would be a lot of problems. I would say they had at least two, and I would say, how many said they had one? One.
One said they had one.
That's right. All of the rest had more.
And all of the rest had more what?
Bathrooms.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
How'd you know that?
Thought of that.
Oh. Kevin will be higher or lower than one.
It's going to be higher. That would be a madhouse. I mean, I couldn't imagine these poor ladies having one bathroom. There's no way.
So he said one of the 10 said they had only one bathroom. Okay? Will it be higher or lower than one? Otherwise, your reasoning didn't match your answers, my friend.
They need more bathrooms.
Oh, I know they need more bathrooms, Kevin. Yeah. Yeah, if they got 10 kids, they need to live in a Holiday Inn somewhere is where they need to live. Yeah. But he said one of the 10 said they only had one bathroom. So will it be higher or lower than...
Higher.
Okay, you still say it's higher. All right. Action number of these moms whose home had only one bathroom is... One. Right on the button. Do you realize, Eli, if that one person down there had one more bathroom, you wouldn't get this $100?
I know.
Boy.
Thank you.
You're welcome. We have $100 to share with our ladies down there. Who had only one bathroom? Calvina. How many children do you have, Calvina?
I have 13 children.
Woo! And you have one bathroom.
We had one bathroom and one bucket.
One bathroom, one bucket. Thank you, ladies, very much. All right. Woo! Eli, you got the control. Here we go. Here's a card for you. It's a five. Player change.
I'm gonna change the card.
Change the card. All right, Lacey's got a new one for you. The five is now a seven.
Higher.
Lucky number seven. Higher. It is not higher. No. All right, Kevin. Here we go, Kev. There's a four.
Higher.
Going higher. Yeah.
Lower.
You got it.
Freeze.
Freeze. It's tough to keep up with, isn't it? We'll be back in just a moment with more card sharks right after this.
Are you laughing?
Welcome back to Card Sharks. We're going to continue with game number one between our champion Eli and our challenger Kevin. And Kevin, this is your question. Kevin, we surveyed 100 men in their 40s who are divorced and dating. Got this right? You want to take some notes?
I'm taking them in my head.
Okay. And we asked them, when you go on a date with a gorgeous girl, do you ever find yourself wishing, if only my ex-wife could see me now? How many divorced men have wished that?
Man, that is going to be way high because I have broken up with a girlfriend before, and then, you know, like, when she breaks up with me, and man, just to put it back in her face, I want to say, this, watch this, baby. And, like, I'm gonna have this beautiful girl walking down there with me and everything, and I'm going to say, eat your heart out. So I'm going to say it's going to be about 71. 71. 71 guys say that they want their ex-wife to see them. That's right. Yeah.
Seven.
He scares me to death, Eli. He acts like he knows what he's talking about, and he's still in high school. That's what's frightening. Will it be higher or lower than 71, Eli?
Well, I believe it definitely be of the people who would want to. Would you repeat it?
Yeah,
for me?
Yeah. He said 71 out of 100 divorced men have wished, when they're with a gorgeous girl, have said, oh, if my ex-wife could only see me now.
Okay, but you said it's people in their 40s.
Yeah, in their 40s.
Yeah, no, that would be the thinking of a younger man. An older man, he says, forget it, divorce, she's out of my mind. I'm going out for a good time. Be lower. Go.
Actual number of divorced men of which their ex-wife could see their gorgeous date is 59. It was lower, but not much lower. All right, it's Eli. Want to change the seven?
Change.
We'll do it. Watch your head, Lacey. Here we go.
Okay.
Seven to nine. Lower than the nine. No. Hey, Kevin, you got a free chance.
Higher
than the nine. It is.
Yes. Lower.
If it's lower, Kevin, if it's lower, you win game number one and $100. Is it lower?
No, it's lower.
No, it's not.
Oh, no.
Just
why are you greedy?
Don't let greed set in now, son. It'll be okay. Next question. Eli, this is your question. We surveyed 100 driving instructors, and we asked them, are men better drivers than women? How many driving instructors said men are better drivers? I just thought of a joke.
I would say that's going to be a fairly high number, without being chauvinistic, because the women... a little apprehensive, I think, when they get in the car to drive the first time, especially with a driving instructor. I'm going to go at 67.
You better duck. 67 out of 100 driving instructors said men are better drivers. Let's check with the champ over here. Yes, Kevin?
I believe it's going to be lower because the girls have confidence. My girlfriend has confidence behind her. She's a crazy woman. So, but she drives good. She's crazy, but she drives good. And my mom and a lot of ladies I know drive really good. So, and they say they've always drive good. So I guess you gotta believe them. So I'm gonna go low.
The actual number of driving instructors who said men are better drivers is 41.
Yeah,
he's right. It was lower.
Change that car.
Okay.
Nine becomes a 10, Kevin.
Lower.
All right, is it lower than a 10? It is.
Higher.
If it's higher, you win the game. No. This will make you an old man, Kevin. I just want you to know that. Free chance, Eli.
Lower.
Lower than the nine.
Higher.
Got it. Is it higher? It is. Uh-huh. No guts, no glory, Eli. He freezes right there. We're going to play Sudden Death when we come back. We'll do that right after these important words.
Monday on my YouTube channel.
We have returned. We're going to play Sudden Death now, guys. This is our fourth and final question of this game. Someone has to win the game on the next play of the cards, and control is really important here. Kevin, this is your question, and here it is. You're a bachelor, of course.
Yeah.
Are you married?
No.
I see. We surveyed 100 bachelors who are being kept by a woman. Are you being kept by a woman, Kevin?
Me and my girlfriend are keeping each other.
Anyway, we asked these guys who are being kept by a woman. Be honest now. The last time you bought a present for your lady, did you pay for it with her money? How many of those bachelors admitted they bought their lady's last present with her own money?
I don't really think that's going to be too high because guys don't do that. I'm going to say 28
out of 100 bachelors admitted that they did that. Eli, what do you think about this,
I would
sir?
Say it'd have to be a higher number because if he's being kept by her, it's a normal thing for her to lay out the dough.
It's the only money he's got,
that's
right?
That's all. A little higher.
Yeah.
Higher.
That's why you're wearing the power tie.
That's right.
Actual number of bachelors who bought their lady's last present with her money is 44 of them. You're right, Eli. All right, we're playing Sudden Death now. Eli, you know what your choices are. You can change the 8 and play it out. If you goof, he wins the game, or pass it on to Kevin. He must play off the 10. If he goofs, you
change
win.
Change the 8.
Change the 8 and play it yourself, all right? The 8 will now become a queen for you.
Lower!
Lower than the queen. 7's your card. If it's, okay, if it's higher, Eli wins the game. If it's not higher, Kevin wins the game. Is it higher than the 7? It is not. Yeah! Kevin wins the game. And there's $100 for you. Kevin, congratulations,
sir.
Game number one. If you win the next game, you're our champ, Eli. You got to try to keep that from happening. And Lacey's going to deal out cards in the very same deck. And let's get game number two going right now. Here's this is yours, Eli. You ever been in prison?
No, not yet.
You ever been in jail?
Honestly? Jail? No.
No. We surveyed 100 men who are serving time in prison. We asked them, if you learned there was going to be a prison break, would you tell the warden? How many inmates claim they would tell the warden?
That would be a very low number because there's a bond between the prisoners. They would not snitch on each other. So I'm going to say it's a low number. I'll say in the area of about 32.
32 out of 100 inmates claim they would tell the warden. Kevin?
I'm going to say it's going to be a little higher because if I was in there and I had a long time left, man, you might be able to get out and just say, hey, buddy. So I'm going to say it's going to be a little higher.
Actual number of inmates who would tell the warden if there's going to be a prison break is 41 of them. I'm surprised at that. I thought you would die after that. I'm really amazed at that. All right, Kevin, here we go. This is your card. 5, player change.
Higher. Let's go higher. Higher.
Keep the card and go higher. 6 is it now.
Higher.
Going higher than the 6. 8.
Freeze.
Freeze. Certainly we will. We'll freeze on the 08. Okay, let's go to another question. Kevin, this is your question. It involves our 10 moms who have at least 10 children in our studio audience. There they are. First of all, congratulations for having 10 children, because I think it's just wonderful that you do that. Before the show, we asked these 10 moms, have you ever punished one kid for something another kid had done? How many of these 10 moms have punished one kid for something another kid had done?
Oh, boy, that's a toughie. I don't have any idea, so I'm just going to say 3.
3 of them.
I don't have any idea. I'm going to say higher.
I don't have any idea. I'm going to say all of them. Heck, we've all done that, haven't we? Okay, you won't admit it, then all 3 of you turn over. In their case, all 10 of them turn over. The actual number of these moms who have punished one kid for something another kid did is 7 of them. Yes, it was certainly higher. Which 7 of you ladies have done that? Raise your hand if you would, please. Mary, I thought sure it'd be 10, didn't you?
Yeah, I think it really should have been.
What happened, Mary?
Well, we were going to go to the park, and we were in the van, and I couldn't see who was fighting in the back. So we got to the park. I spanked everyone when they got out and said, have a good time.
Wait a minute. So each one went out, you spanked them and said, had a good time, right? Gosh. And you probably had a sore hand and they didn't care. Thank you, ladies, very much. All right. Eli, you ready? Eli, there's an ace.
Hey, Loa, Loa.
Loa. Ace is now at 10.
Loa.
Loa again. Is it low? No, it is not. Kevin, a free chance with the 8.
Higher, higher.
Is it higher than the 8? It is not higher than the 8. No, 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 no. All right, we'll pause for some words. We'll be right back with more card sharks right after this.
Laugh with William Shatner on TV's funniest game show moments. Now that's funny. Tonight at 8 on Buzzer.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Let's go right on to another question now to find out who's going to win this game. Will it be Eli or will it be Kevin? Eli, this is your question. This is an educated guess question. And certainly, Eli, we're going to ask you to give us a good educated guess. You ready?
Ready.
What percentage of all the people who wait on restaurant tables in the United States are women? What percentage?
68%.
Let's see what Kevin says.
I'm going to say a bit higher.
I think it's a bit higher than that. The actual percentage of people who wait on tables who are women is 88%. Yes, it was definitely higher. And Kevin's got the control. Change that card, he said. All right, Kevin, there for you is a 7.
Higher.
Is it higher than a 7? No, it is not higher than a 7. Eli's got the ace as a base card. Lower, the man says.
Higher
than the 8? Yes.
Freezing
the 9. All right, he's tied up the game by freezing right there. Kevin, we're going to play sudden death, you guys. Fourth and final question. Someone has to win the game. In the next play, if it's Kevin, he's the new champ. If it's Eli, we play tiebreaker. Kevin, surveyed 100 taxi cab drivers. We asked them, have you ever been mugged by a passenger? How many cab drivers said they have been mugged by a passenger?
I think that a lot of cab drivers would have, and I think that that's going to be about 62
out of 100, so they've been mugged by a passenger, Eli?
No, we're not that bad. We low.
Probably depends on what city, huh?
Yeah.
All right. The actual number of cab drivers who have been mugged by a passenger is 31 of them. Yeah, it was lower. Sudden death, Eli. You know what your choices are, my friend. You change the 9 and play it out, or you can pass it on to Kevin. He has to play off the 7. All right, Kevin. It's
higher.
Higher than the 7. It is not higher than the 7. Eli wins the game, and we play tiebreaker. All right. Very quickly, we're going to play a tiebreaker game now. You know what the tiebreakers are. One question, sudden death. Lacey will deal out only 3 cards this time. Winner of this game is our champ. Eli, the question is yours. Surveyed 100 women business executives. We ask them, which do you think requires the greater effort, a successful marriage or a successful career? How many women executives said a successful marriage takes the greater effort?
I would say... marriage is tough now with all the divorces that are going around. I would say it would be a rather high number, and let's go about 69.
69 out of 100 women executives said a successful marriage takes a greater effort. What do you think, Kevin?
I'm going to say lower.
You think it's lower? Actual number of women executives who said a successful marriage takes the greater effort is 87 of them. Was it lower or was higher? Eli, sudden death. I will show you your base card. I'll show you Kevin's base card. You make the decision off of that. Eli, your base card is a 6, and Kevin's base card is a 10. You going to play it? You going to pass it?
Pass.
Going to pass it to Kevin. Kevin, it's all up to you, my friend. Make one goof, and Eli is the champ.
Lower.
Lower than the 10, it is lower.
Higher.
If it's higher, you're our new champ.
Yep.
And Kevin, you've done it.
Thank you very much.
Us with $4,250. Thank you very much for being with us. You're a nice man. We'll see you. Come on, Kevin. Come right over here, my friend.
Over here.
MC stands on this side. Okay? And we'll be right back to see if this young man can win a lot of money right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Well, champ, this is it. Got a chance to win a lot of money over there. We've added a couple of jokers whenever they pop up. You know that gives you another chance of winning that great little red truck back there. And because you're the champ, Lacey's got one joker for you. So we want to wish you all the luck in the world, all right? Give him some money, $200 to bet with. You're on your way. Come on, Kevin. Let's win a lot of money now. First card happens to be a 6, and you got $200. You can play or change.
Change with 3.
Number 3. He's going to change the 6. The 6 now becomes an 8. He's still got $200.
50 lower.
$50. Lower than the 8. All right. You're now at $150, Kevin.
$50 lower.
$50 lower again, he says. It's lower this time. Back to $200.
$200. All of it higher.
Gonna bet it all. He says all of it higher than the four.
Good. Yeah. Yeah.
Now you got four up here. I'll give you another four. You now have $800, the six again.
Let's go 100 higher.
Gonna keep the six.
100 higher.
$100 higher than the six. No. Okay. Back to $700.
$700. How much I have?
700.
300 higher.
$300 higher than the three. There you are. $1,000.
Change it with one.
Gonna change the 10. He's got $1,000, and the 10 will become a three. Good for you.
$1,000. $800 higher.
$800 higher than the three.
Yeah!
$1,800. Up here, the queen is your card. You got to bet at least 900, Kevin.
A grand lower.
That's $1,000.
$1,000 lower.
$1,000 lower than the queen. It is. And there's $2,800. You already have $200. You got $3,000. And we'll give him a chance to win the new car when we meet next time. So long, everybody, from Card Shark. Bye-bye. So
this is Gene Wood speaking for Card Shark. A Mark Goodson television production.
Tomorrow on Knowledge in Lady Luck Tuesday. Well, tomorrow we have a game of luck, game of knowledge, game of Lady Luck. Oh, and it's hard game. Oh, Tony, would Tony win more? Find out tomorrow. Here is the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
Thank you, Johnny. Thank you, players. And hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to Jeopardy, our game of trivia with a twist. I supply the answers, and these three players have to come up with the questions. Should be a lively game today because we have two teachers, a high school teacher and a college professor, and a very bright returning champion. I will assume for the moment that all of you people watching at home are familiar with our rules, so I will dispense with those. Let's get right to it. Let's play the first round of Jeopardy.
Will you have a knowledge of luck of these answers? Fine. Will these guys have knowledge of these answers of these categories?
The categories for today.
Tune in tomorrow.
Always interesting. Baseball, odd jobs, movies, Australia, and finally, category. Category. With the word cat, of course, in quotation marks, and you know what that means. Tony, you had a very good time on our last program.
I really
you
did, Alex. I enjoyed myself.
Won a lot of money. Let's see how well you do today. Start things off for us, if you will.
Okay, I'd like to start with politics for 100, please.
The answer is...
So tune in for Knowledge in Lady Luck Tuesdays tomorrow morning. Same time, 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m.
Excitement with the all-new Card Shark. Hi there, I'm Bob Eubanks, inviting you to join the fun as fortunes are made for the turn of a single card. Tune in weekdays for the all-new Card Shark.
On Card Shark, the rumor is out.
Change that sucker.
See it on CBS. See what?
Excitement's the name of the game every morning on CBS.
Rumor.
That's better.
On Card Sharks, weekdays.
Weekday mornings, it's Card Sharks, and people just go crazy with fun.
Higher! Ah! Higher! Oh!
Because it's all in the cards.
There you go.
And the cards keep turning up winners.
Do you? Yeah! Is it there?
Card Sharks. Pure excitement weekdays.
This is CBS.